गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ कमलनाथ एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माई क्लास ऑफ ग्रामर। स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक टूडे, एडजेक्टिव्स। द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इन योर ग्रामर इज एडजेक्टिव्स एंड वी शैल लर्न डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ एडजेक्टिव्स। सो बिफोर गोइंग फर्दर टू नो द काइंड्स, लेट अस नो what is adjective. Adjective is a word which tells or describes something about a noun or pronoun in the sentence. Adjectives are the words which describe nouns or pronouns in the sentence. Let us see through some examples. Ram is a good boy. Here, before boy is where good used. Good is describing Ram. What kind of boy Ram is? Ram is a good boy. So here word good is describing Ram. It is telling something about Ram. So good is an adjective. Mohan is an intelligent boy. Here, what kind of boy is Mohan? If you ask question, what kind of boy is Mohan? You will get the answer, intelligent boy. If you are asking, my brother is very polite. What is here polite? It is describing about my brother. What kind of boy is my brother? My brother is a polite boy. So in this way, we see the words which describes to the meaning of noun or pronoun, they are called adjectives. She has four pencils. Here before pencils, what is here used? Four. So that four is here describing about the number of pencils. That is here adjectives. So we shall learn different kinds of adjectives in this chapter. In this class, you have been given 9 kinds of adjectives. Adjectives of quality, adjectives of quantity, adjectives of number, demonstrative adjective, distributive adjectives, emphasizing adjectives, possessive adjectives, interrogative adjectives and proper adjectives. These are 9 kinds of adjectives we have to learn in this class. So let us see here about adjectives. There is something more you have to remember and you have just to learn forever and ever. Adjectives are words that are used to describe nouns or pronouns. Or in other way you may tell, an adjective makes the meaning of a noun or a pronoun more clear. We have already discussed the examples. Let us see. An adjective modifies or gives more information about a noun or pronoun. That means adjectives tell about the quality, quantity, number, or order of the noun that it describes. Let us proceed now and learn more about adjectives. As I told you, there are 9 kinds of adjectives. So let us know one by one. Adjectives of quality. As I told you, adjectives can be of various types. The first type of adjective is the adjective of quality. What is adjective of quality? An adjective of quality describes the quality of a noun. It answers the question of what kind. Mohan is a polite boy. What kind of Mohan is? Mohan is a polite boy. The answer will be polite. So this polite gives the answer of what kind. This is a big glass. What kind of glass it is? a big glass. So here big is here answering the question of what kind. So an adjective answers, adjective of quality answers the question of what kinds. So let us see here further some more examples. Adjective of quality. The hungry fox chased a cat. What kind of fox chased a cat? The hungry fox. So before fox, that is a noun. Fox is a noun. And before fox is hungry. The hungry fox chased a cat. So hungry is here describing the fox, the noun. And so hungry is adjective here. Hungry is adjective in this sentence. So adjective of quantity. Next one is adjective of quantity. We learnt adjective of quality and now is adjective of quantity. Adjective of quantity tells the quantity of something. Adjective of quantity answers the question how much. And whatever answer we get, that will be our adjectives of quantity. Adjectives of quantity mostly describe uncountable nouns. You know, you have read, there are two kinds of nouns, uncountable and countable. Countable nouns are the nouns which can be counted. Books, books are countable nouns. Chairs are countable noun. Shirt is countable noun. House is countable noun. People are countable noun. So these are countable noun. And uncountable noun like water. You cannot count water. You cannot count milk. You cannot count air. So these are called uncountable nouns. So let us see further adjective of quantity. There is little water to drink. There is little water to drink. You can see in the glass, little water. Little is showing the quantity. Means there is little water. There is not much water. There is little water to drink. So the word little, yeah, the little that is here, describes about the quantity of the water. How much water? Little, not much. Little. So this modifies or this describe about the quantity of water. How much water? Little water. So that is called, this little word describes about the noun water. And so little is here adjective of quantity. I have enough milk. I have enough milk. What is enough? Enough is not countable. It is telling about the quantity. Enough. And that's why word enough is adjective of quantity. You know already enough. What is enough? Enough you have read here. Enough you have already named here. Enough. Enough is we. Enough. Adjective of quantity. Enough. So my dear, in this way, you have learned adjective of quantity. Students, as I told you, adjective of number is of two types. That is, ordinal number and cardinal number. Adjective of number is of two kinds. That is, cardinal number and ordinal number. What is cardinal number? When you are counting the numbers in the normal way, general way, like 1, 2, 3 pence, 4 pence, 5 pence, 100 people, 200 people, 500 buses. So in this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so these numbers when you are counting, that is called cardinal number. But when you tell the same thing, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, seventh, tenth, then this here order is called ordinal numbers. In that way, that is called ordinal number. So students, this is here remember adjective of answer. Here adjective of number answers the question how many. When you ask there, then you will get the answer of question how many. I will be absent for 6 days. See here, I will be absent for 6 days. Here, how many days? The answer comes 6 days. So 6 before here noun days is here adjective. It is telling here the number of days. So it is describing the number of days. It is informing. It is giving the information of number of days. So it is modifying. And so it is called adjective of number. Students, here adjective of number can be in other way also, that answers the question in what order. Right now I explained you cardinal number and ordinal number. Right now that you learned, here 6, 7, 8, 9, these are cardinal number. And you see here the example, I stood in the third row. So here third is ordinal number. This is called ordinal number. So students, let us know one thing that is important. Adjective of number, all cardinal and ordinal numbers are adjectives, and that is adjective of number. All cardinal number that I have right now given you examples, or ordinal number I have given you examples, they all are adjective of number. Some adjectives are used with countable as well as uncountable nouns. They are used with both. Like here you can see, I have some dishes. You can see here dishes. Dishes is what here? Countable. Because you can see here two dishes. We can count the dish. Like we can count the book. We can count the pen. We can count chair. We can count benches. We can count house. Like that we can count dish. So I have some dishes means dish is countable. So some before that is countable noun. That is countable noun. Some is here countable noun. But at the same time when you see the next sentence, I have some food. So here food is not countable. Food cannot be counted. So here some is used as uncountable noun. I have some food. So some in this sentence is uncountable noun because food cannot be counted. So in this way, some is used in both ways, as a countable noun and uncountable noun both. Let us see now. Next one. An adjective usually comes before the noun it describes or modifies. This is a huge palace. We generally know that adjectives comes before a noun. But it is not always that adjectives will come before a noun or pronoun. Sometimes adjectives comes after the noun or pronoun in the sentence. Let us see through some examples. This is a huge palace. Here huge is used before palace. Palace is noun and before that huge is used. But in the second sentence you see, an adjective may also come immediately beside the noun it describes. Just immediate the noun it is describing. You can see, the heat made the child sleepy. The heat made the child sleepy. Means due to the heat, the child felt sleepy. Here sleepy is adjective. It is describing about child, that is noun. But sleepy has been used here immediate after the noun, that is child. Child is noun and sleepy is adjective. Sleepy has been used just after noun. So students, these are important thing for us to learn. Let us know now the fourth type of adjective. What is that? Demonstrative adjective. Demonstrative adjective. What is demonstrative adjective? Demonstrative adjectives answers the question which. In other way, you may learn demonstrative adjectives are those adjectives which indicate people or things which are far or near to us, to point out the people or things which are near to us or far from us, to point out them. These demonstrative adjectives are used. So let us see here how that you can. This boy is stronger than my brother. This boy is stronger than my brother. Here you are pointing a boy who is standing near you. This boy. This boy is stronger than my brother. Like that you may say, these grapes are sour. These grapes are sour. So here you are pointing out some grapes which are kept near you. And you are pointing towards the grapes, telling that these grapes are sour. So demonstrative adjective answers the question which. You may see some examples. This stain, before stain, this, that apple, that shows the objects or people, things or people at far distance when you are pointing. So that apple denote that apple is here a little farther from you. So let us see now next. Those shoes, here those, these books, these are used to point out or indicate the objects or people which are nearer to us. And those demonstrative are used to point out people or things which are far from us. So you can see the girl is standing and she is pointing to our shoes, which is really far from her. And here you can see the boy who is showing the books, which is quite close to him. So these, those, this or that, these are demonstrative adjectives, because these are used to indicate the people or things which are near or far from us, to indicate, to point out them. So student, you have learned here today adjectives and its four kinds. Four kinds you have learned today. That was adjective of quality, adjective of quantity, adjective of number, and demonstrative adjectives. And I am sure you must have learned them nicely. And next day again, we shall learn more in the session. That will be next adjectives, distributive adjectives, emphasizing adjectives, possessive adjectives, interrogative adjectives, and proper adjectives. We shall learn next day. Till then, goodbye. Thank you very much for joining the class. Thank you.